There are two very different stories when it comes to steroids. The first is one of hope. The other is one of overindulgence and addiction. There are types of steroids that can save your life. However, when steroids are taken in excess and without the approval of a medical professional, they can also lead to your death. Which type of steroid should you never put in your body? Let's find out. At a basic level, steroids are synthetically created hormones that the adrenal glands in your body produce normally. Hormones are chemical messengers that tell your cell which biological processes they should carry out. For example, the hormone insulin signals your cell to take in more sugar from your bloodstream and use it to create energy. The human body also uses hormones such as testosterone and estrogen to signal different physiological changes during someone's life. These hormones can also aid in the growth of muscles, which will come into play later. Corticosteroids are the steroids most often prescribed by doctors due to their anti-inflammatory properties. They have a number of applications and can aid in recovery of countless medical conditions. The other, more dangerous type of steroids are anabolic androgenic steroids. These are the steroids that bodybuilders and athletes use to enhance their muscle strength and performance. It's these types of steroids that can be dangerous if used incorrectly. First, let's understand why steroids, if used properly, can help you or even save your life. Again, remember that most steroids need to be prescribed by a doctor to ensure the right dosage and type of steroid is given. You're struggling to breathe. Every time you take in air, it feels like your windpipe has been sealed shut. You scramble for your inhaler and fumble it. The precious device falls to the ground. Your lungs feel like they're going to explode as you reach down to pick up the device. You stick the inhaler in your mouth and push down. A cool, moist mixture of air is forced down your throat. For a moment, you hold your breath and then, with a sigh of relief, you breathe out, and you can now gulp down the much-needed air. Your chest heaves up and down as your lungs once again bring in oxygen and release CO2. People with asthma suffer from long-term chronic inflammation and swollen muscles in their airways. When the airway becomes inflamed, the body also produces extra mucus, all of which blocks the airway and causes difficulty breathing. It's the swollen muscles that the mixture of steroids and bronchodilators in an inhaler help to relieve. The anti-inflammatory effects of steroids allows the muscles to relax and the person to begin breathing normally again. When steroids bind to the membranes of muscle cells in the throat, they signal the cells to shrink in size through a series of biological processes. This causes the swelling in the throat to go down and allows the person to breathe normally again. It's absolutely terrifying for those several seconds that someone is having an asthma attack and can't breathe. Their body is literally choking them to death and depriving them of the oxygen they so desperately need. An asthma attack can become life-threatening without the aid of the anti-inflammatory signals the steroids and inhalers send to the muscle cells. This is just one way steroids can be used to save lives. Doctors can prescribe steroids for a number of different reasons. Many times, they're used to relieve uncomfortable conditions that can arise in the body but might not be life-threatening. However, without them, people would be in an incredible amount of pain and discomfort. So you're sitting at home when your eczema begins itching like crazy. The condition is caused by an overactive immune system along with environmental factors that affect the skin. As you scratch and scratch and try to relieve the discomfort, it feels like your skin is on fire. The swollen part of your body becomes so inflamed that you just want to cut off the entire body part and be done with it. Luckily, the doctor prescribed you steroids to help reduce the inflammation and return the skin to its normal state. The steroids can either be taken in pill form or by rubbing a cream on the infected area. If taken orally, the pills are broken down in the digestive tract and then diffuse into the bloodstream, where they're carried around your body by the circulatory system. When they reach the inflamed site, the steroids bind to the muscle and skin cells and signal them to carry out the process to reduce inflammation. Similarly, when a cream containing steroids is applied directly to the body, they bind to the skin cells and suppress the immune response that's causing the irritation and inflammation. Although eczema is uncomfortable, there's another disease that is much more painful and even life-threatening that steroids can help with. For inflammatory bowel diseases such as Crohn's and IBS, steroids can help reduce some of the most intense discomforts of someone's life. These diseases cause the gastrointestinal tract to become inflamed, resulting in truly nasty side effects. Medical professionals are not entirely sure what the exact cause of Crohn's or other inflammatory bowel diseases is, but the swelling in this region of the body is due to the fact that the immune system is attacking the cells, which causes irritation and swelling. Doctors think these conditions might be caused by a virus or a bacteria infecting the cells in the gastrointestinal tract, but no single pathogen has been identified as a culprit yet. In these situations, doctors will prescribe steroids that reduce the swelling in the intestines and bowels to allow waste to pass through the system more easily. If left untreated, the excretory system might become backed up with waste, which would eventually start to poison the body. In these circumstances, bowel inflammation can become life-threatening, and surgery must be conducted to remove the scar tissue causing the blockage. Before this point, however, doctors will prescribe steroids to aid in reducing inflammation and get the swelling under control. When the steroids bind to the cells in the colon and the intestinal tissue, they suppress the immune system in the region, allowing the inflammation to go down and waste to flow out of the body. There are some side effects to taking steroids prescribed by doctors, such as an increase in appetite, mood changes, and difficulty sleeping. These are all a result of the chemical composition in your body being changed by the steroids and the process they trigger. Don't forget that steroids mimic hormones, which signal changes to occur in the cells of your body. And although steroids might be used for the anti-inflammatory properties, they also change the chemical levels in your body, which will inevitably affect multiple organs and tissues. This brings us to the really nasty things that steroids can do to you. You have probably heard that people who abuse steroids can have lower sperm count or suddenly explode into fits of rage. And although this may be true, there are some much, much worse side effects that result from steroid abuse. The type of steroids that are often misused are called anabolic androgenic steroids, which is also abbreviated as AAS. These are the types of steroids that people take to increase their metabolism and build larger muscles. AAS is typically a synthetic form of testosterone, but females and males produce testosterone naturally. It's one of the hormones in the body responsible for growth, and in males, testosterone signals the body to develop male characteristics during puberty. In women, testosterone also plays an important role in growth and development. However, it's present in much lower quantities in females than males. People have found that by using AAS to trick the body into thinking there is testosterone present, it speeds up the growth of muscles. This is by no means a healthy process, and although it can create the desired results of muscle growth, abusing anabolic androgenic steroids can have some serious consequences. So, what actually happens to your body if you take these types of steroids? Well, muscle mass will certainly increase, but everything else that'll happen should make you think twice before pumping your body full of AAS. Performance-enhancing drugs such as anabolic androgenic steroids are banned in most sports and competitions. Each year, athletes who are caught using steroids are fined heavily and forced to forfeit their right to compete. Therefore, it seems crazy to use steroids as the risks far outweigh the gains, yet it still happens all the time. Imagine you're an athlete who's obsessed with gaining bigger muscles so that you can be stronger and faster than your competitors. You train hard but hit a plateau, so you decide to take steroids to enhance your performance. After every workout session, your muscle fibers are stretched or torn apart. Your body naturally repairs any damage, which results in more muscle mass developing. But if you can trick your body into thinking it's also growing at the same time, muscle creation will increase exponentially. You pump iron all day to break your muscles down, then gulp down an energy drink full of steroids. These steroids circulate around your body and attach to your muscle cells. They signal the cells to produce more proteins to aid in the repair and strengthening of your muscles. Simultaneously, the steroids trigger cell division, causing the body to create more muscle cells. These processes can create a hormone imbalance, which may cause your body to start developing characteristics that it shouldn't, while also affecting your brain chemistry. Neither the growth of the muscles nor the unpleasant side effects develop right away. It may take weeks for these things to happen to your body, but it's estimated that anabolic androgenic steroids increase strength by around 5 to 20%, which is why people abuse AAS. Each time you take steroids, the cells in your body ramp up protein synthesis. This is important for muscle growth, but can also lead to the overdevelopment of certain male traits. This happens in both men and women who take anabolic androgenic steroids. Since your cells are working harder, they require more energy, which is why you experience an increase in appetite. The feeling of hunger is just your brain telling you that your body needs more nutrients to make more energy. Anabolic androgenic steroids also trigger the body to break down fat stores and use the fuel in them to increase muscle mass and promote growth. This causes body fat to decrease drastically in people who take steroids. The steroids also signal the body to create more red blood cells to aid in oxygen delivery around the body, so more energy can be made. These might all seem like good things, but it's what comes next that should worry you. Anabolic and androgenic steroids contain a combination of different chemicals. It's the ratio between the anabolic chemicals and the androgenic chemicals that determines what the steroid actually does to your body. Anabolic refers to chemicals that signal and promote muscle growth, while androgenic signifies the chemicals that promote the development of male sex traits. A steroid needs to contain both these properties to work effectively. For example, a steroid that only contains anabolic chemicals will not allow muscles to grow at the desired rate due to the fact that the other hormones and proteins are needed to facilitate the process that can only be triggered by androgenic chemicals. The ratio of androgenic to anabolic steroids can also cause a certain negative reaction in the body to occur. Using steroids increases your blood pressure and heart rate, as the body needs to circulate nutrients more quickly to fulfill the needs of the cells that are now producing more proteins and dividing more frequently. Unfortunately, both high blood pressure and heart rate can lead to heart disease or stroke. Therefore, the very thing the steroids are telling your body to do might also kill you. With a steroid that simulates testosterone, like with many anabolic androgenic steroids, there are some mental side effects as well. One of the byproducts of high levels of testosterone, especially in males, is that they can become aggressive and prone to mood swings. Again, this is due to an imbalance in chemical levels as a direct result of the steroid stimulating protein synthesis, among other cellular processes. The new proportions of biochemicals in the body affect the neural pathways and the composition of the chemicals in your brain. When these symptoms are taken to the extreme, it can cause you to lose control of rational thought and lash out in aggressive ways. This has come to be known as roid rage. There also seems to be a correlation between steroid use and body image disorders. The chemical imbalance caused by anabolic androgenic steroids might distort your view of your own body and push you to work out more to lose fat you don't have and gain more muscle. This is a vicious cycle, because if your brain is telling you that you don't look good and that your body should be more muscular, you'll likely take more steroids in order to reach an unobtainable body image. This leads to steroid abuse and is relatively common for people who use AAS without consulting their doctor. In these circumstances, steroids are not just messing with your biochemical processes, they've also become an addictive drug. Anabolic androgenic steroids themselves might not be classified as addictive, but what they do to your brain chemistry can make you crave them as if they were a drug you can't get enough of. While you gain muscle and the biochemical processes in your body are altered due to the steroids, other dangerous side effects are occurring. The liver filters blood while also balancing nutrients and metabolizing certain chemicals, such as the complex molecules found in steroids. When you take steroids, it forces your liver to work overtime to break down the chemicals in the drugs and the byproducts generated by the increased levels of protein synthesis happening around your body. Protein synthesis, like most cellular processes, generates waste, which also needs to be broken down by the liver. What this means is that steroids overwork the liver. People who abuse steroids never allow their liver to rest or recover, which leads to complications or liver failure later on. This is when steroids become life-threatening. It doesn't really matter if anabolic androgenic steroids give you larger muscles if your liver fails and you die. There are also other more noticeable side effects of taking anabolic androgenic steroids. Females might start growing hair on their faces where they normally wouldn't. Their voice might deepen while their breast size decreases. Other changes, such as an enlarged clitoris and irregular menstrual cycle, also occur. All of these side effects are a direct result of the chemical and hormone imbalances that happen within the body as a result of taking anabolic androgenic steroids. For males, there are some much more strange physical side effects. Abuse of anabolic androgenic steroids can cause gynecomastia. This is a condition in males where the breast gland tissue increases due to an imbalance in the hormones estrogen and testosterone. When this happens, breasts grow in size. Gynecomastia usually affects both breasts, but sometimes only causes one to grow extra tissue. Either way, this condition does not provide more upper body strength and is therefore not the desired result of most people using steroids. Although most anabolic androgenic steroids mimic the hormone testosterone in some way, they are not always a perfect substitute. In fact, abuse of steroids can actually lead to hypogonadism, which is a condition that causes the testes in males and ovaries in females to stop or produce very small amounts of sex hormones, such as estrogen and testosterone. When this happens in males, it can cause the testicles to shrink. In both sexes, it can render the person infertile. Again, this is a perfect example of how steroids can produce big muscles, but with consequences. Is risking the ability to have future offspring worth increasing your muscle mass and becoming stronger for a brief period of time? For some, it is. But for many younger athletes who start taking steroids, they don't know the risks or consequences these drugs have on their bodies later in life. Some of the most severe consequences of using anabolic androgenic steroids are the long-term health effects they have. In order to build bigger muscles, your body needs to increase hemoglobin production along with a number of red blood cells to deliver more oxygen to your cells. This oxygen is then used to create different proteins and energy. However, increased levels of blood cells and hemoglobin can thicken your blood and increase your chances of having a heart attack even after you stop taking the steroids. Anabolic androgenic steroids are also known to have long-term effects on your cholesterol levels. Research shows that these steroids can reduce your HDL cholesterol while raising your LDL cholesterol, basically It increases bad cholesterol overall throughout the body. Again, this has nasty consequences for your heart and can lead to several other complications. The use of steroids to increase muscle size and strength is just not a healthy alternative to working out and eating a well-balanced diet. Athletes and bodybuilders will take steroids to gain an advantage over their competition, but at a great cost to their bodies. If you take anabolic androgenic steroids, there's a good chance you'll not only experience unintended physical side effects, but your brain, heart, and liver will suffer as well. The short-term gains are never worth the long-term damage that anabolic androgenic steroids can cause. That's why they should only be taken when prescribed by medical professionals and in specific circumstances. Now watch what happens to your body if you never move, or check out what happens to your body when you stop drinking alcohol.